has to say.
Well, I know you said, I guess that means that if Piper shows up, we're going to have a match here tonight,
well,
Piper
yeah.
and Hogan. Well, I can tell you this. Hogan is the biggest liar the sport has ever seen. And you know as well as I know that he realizes what happened at Starrcade. And I think when Piper shows up, you're not going to see him at all.
Well, he did make the comment we're going to do it NWO style, which tells me he's going to have about 50 rats, you know, hiding in different corners like Scott Hall and Nash and Six.
The former Cruiserweight Champion, the Ultimo Dragon, and Rey Mendoza Jr. from Mexico in the opening bout here. Two great Cruiserweights. Mendoza's shoulder block with a handspring. And Mendoza goes to the bottom rope to the floor.
I tell you, the Ultimo Dragon, this guy is terrific. The guy that combined all the Cruiserweight titles. Mendoza hit the rail.
Mendoza staggering backwards that time. The back of the head and the shoulders hit that steel safety rail here. We are at the Mid-South Coliseum, a capacity crowd on hand. Sonny Ono has come out with the Ultimo Dragon. Of course, they want to get that Cruiserweight Championship back, but to do that, Larry, you got to go through the mighty Dean Malenko.
Dean Malenko, and give Sonny Ono credit. He's got the right man, no doubt in my book. The Ultimo Dragon has got to be the number one contender and at least the number one feared man by Malenko. So you can see why this guy's so aggressive, so determined. He wants to get that belt back.
Two count in it? Only a two count as Mendoza gets out of it. This past weekend, we did find out, thanks to Mr. and Ms. Sandy Murray, that the Gaelic interpretation of what Roddy Piper was saying, the last time, here's a cover here, one, two, the last time we saw him on Nitro was the battle is not over until you get home. And that was kind of a loose interpretation, but I think what it means, even though he said it was his last match, is the battle is not over until he says it's over. Arm drag takedown again. Oh, and Mendoza with a running leg.
Well, we can speculate all we want. Piper is going to be here. And that will take care of all questions. What he was mumbling before means nothing. What he says tonight means everything.
It means everything to all of us, to fans of World Championship Wrestling, and to this great, wonderful sport that we've come to love over the years, professional wrestling. And you're tuned in to Pro Wrestling's number one program, Nitro, 2 hours live here tonight. Over the top goes Ultimo Dragon underneath. Oh, he caught him. Got the legs tied up and almost had a three count that time.
Or just couldn't bring the weight over enough, couldn't bend him over those shoulders enough, but that was a surprise for the Dragon. He didn't know where he was. This guy's quick.
Head scissor takeover. Mendoza wobbly gets to his feet that time, and the Ultimo Dragon ties him up one more time.
Well, the guy's got wobbly. He went right back into the corner, which is good, but he stayed there too long. And right here, the Ultimo Dragon, he can nail you from anywhere. The air.
Oh, my goodness. His move off the top, a Frankensteiner-type maneuver. Sonny Ono celebrating on the far side. Referee Mark Curtis still realizing there's more to go. Double chicken wing suplex over the top. One, two, three.
Well, he made that look easy, and that's not an easy maneuver.
That is not. You're right, Larry, but the caliber of athlete the Ultimo Dragon is, he makes them all look easy. The former J. Crown champion, at one time the man owned 9 belts.